long story short, he ended up going to the hotel with Cardi B.
I think it's fucked up. I think it's fucked up. I think it's fucked up.
So welcome back to Badass Conjure TV. I've been gone for like 3 weeks because, of course, the hater flagged my channel. And so I couldn't post a video on here for 2 weeks. I still cannot go live on here for probably like 2 months. But I will be premiering videos and I will be here for it, okay? And I will be, you know, keeping in contact with you guys. If you do want to check me out live, I do go live on Badass Witch Exclusive and on the House of Ajay. I'll post those links to those channels in the description for those of you who are not subscribed. And also for those of you who are not subscribed to this channel, be sure to like, share, subscribe, and comment on the videos, okay? So I wanted to stop by to let y'all know that your favorite narcissist, Miss Tasha K, is back to her old, her old ways. Well, I don't really think she ever stopped, okay? So what's happening is Miss Cardi B is now suing Tasha K and Star Marie, okay? So she had talked about doing this a couple months ago, and I was sitting back wondering and waiting to see if she was actually going to do something, because you don't want to be, you know, a shit talker and talking about what you're going to do and then never do anything. And that is kind of how I think they were looking at her and wasn't expecting anything to come out of it. And now they're both kind of closed mouth about things. They were like on the first day or two, didn't know what they were able to say legally and all of that. And so basically, I want to talk about Tasha more so than the Star Marie chick, because, you know, she ain't that important. But so with Tasha, the thing I wanted to point out about her is that how now that she's being sued, she has gone on another smear campaign. She's gone on a smear campaign like the one she went on when she was feuding with Sweet Mom for Life, okay? So the smear campaign that she tried to go on this time, it's funny to me because there's another YouTuber that I love by the name of Derrick Jaxn. Y'all need to go check him out. I will put a link to his channel in the description as well. Derrick Jaxn basically speaks very highly of women, and he gives women the best advice ever on how to deal with these bullshit ass, you know, nothing ass men, okay? And not saying that all men are bullshit. I'm definitely not a man hater or anything like that, but I don't believe in dating dusties, okay? Okay, the dusties, according to a Sheer Star Goddess. But anyway, you know, there are some dusty ass, you know, men that exist in the world, and basically Derrick Jaxn basically gives women advice on how to avoid these people and how to deal with them, you know, the difficulties of basically shit like that, okay? So what happened is, when Tasha K got the lawsuit and realized that her ass was really getting sued, then she embarked on this smear campaign against Cardi B, okay? So basically what she's trying to do now is, all of a sudden when she, you know, announced that she was suing them for defaming her by basically saying that she was a prostitute, that she used to do mollies in the club, that she had herpes and other lies that were told during the Star Marie interview. What happened was, you know, she said none of that stuff was true, so she's suing they asses. And so basically this video surfaced all of a sudden of Cardi B basically saying, talking about how I think when she was a stripper, she used to drug men up and rob them, okay, which is a common practice among people in that, you know, in that business. But anyway, not condoning it in any way. But then it went from her saying that she had been drugged. I mean, she drugged men and robbed them, to people trying to say she said she drugged people and raped them. Okay, so, you know, sounds like a whole complete lie to to me because she never said that. So anyway, this video starts being passed around, and again, I feel like it was generated with Tasha or her winos, and they're basically trying to create a case where Cardi B is basically has admitted to the things that they have lied on her about, which, you know, that basically was not what happened. So what she also tried to do was get Derrick Jaxn, who is very respected in the YouTube streets, especially by women. She tried to get Derrick Jaxn to, you know, side with her on some bullshit that she was trying to put out there about Cardi, basically trying to say something like, how could you support, I don't remember who it was, Rick Ross or some damn rapper, somebody that, I remember if it was Rick Ross, she was talking about when Rick Ross was talking about how he had gave a girl a Molly or gave a girl some sort of date rape drug and raped her, okay, while she was asleep or some shit like that, okay? And she tried to equate that with what Cardi B said she did, which was basically drug men who wanted to have sex with her and robbed them of their money, okay? So there is no kind of parallel between those two things. But of course, narcs like to exaggerate things and embellish stories to try to destroy their the person that they're jealous of or that they hate, okay? So basically, you know, I feel like Tasha K is basically obsessed with Cardi B, okay? And because she is obsessed and, you know, she has it out for Cardi B, the good thing that happened in the whole thing is that Derrick Jaxn didn't fall for the bullshit, okay? Derrick Jaxn knew exactly what Tasha was trying to do, and he didn't fall for it, okay? Big bitch, I should run a whole blog at this rate. They're using my name for clickbait. Bitches even want to start fake beefs. They sell a little weave in the mixtape. They know I'm the bomb, they're ticking me off. Say anything to get a response. I know that mean the traffic is slow. Somebody just got a project to launch. So for being tame, I'd rather be wild. Bitches is brandy, they want to be down. Soon as these bitches got something to sell, they say my name, Destiny Child.
So as y'all can see, Tasha was trying to manipulate Derrick Jaxn into caping for her and speaking against Cardi B as far as trying to insinuate that she, you know, was drugging and raping people or trying to equate what she admittedly talked about doing in her past with, you know, actually drugging and raping someone. So it wasn't quite the same thing. Derrick Jaxn is no fool. He's no flying monkey for any narcissist. And the ploy didn't work.
I'm like, I'm curious more so the outrage and if there's something deeper behind this outrage. And if that's the case, then my real issue is not so much that Cardi has a fucked up past and at some point did some things that today she's crying about and not happy about and hasn't been held accountable. That's not even my issue anymore. Now it's starting to look like, on some accounts, there's something deeper going on and people are weaponizing the Me Too movement or the momentum from the R. Kelly thing with the rape. They're weaponizing that to take down their least favorite artist, which I think is fucked up.
So instead of thinking what Tasha K, the NARC, was trying to manipulate him into thinking, Derrick Jaxn had his own thoughts.
I think it's fucked up. So as far as, you know, 3 years ago, she was on live. She was ranting and raving about, first mistake is letting anybody get to you and have power over you because they don't give you your proper credit. But second thing is, yeah, she had a fucked up past, grimy past. She was open about it. I mean, you know. And it's being talked about. It's not being swept under the rug. So I don't think it's wrong if she gets held accountable. I don't think it's wrong if her most faithful fans say, I can't support you no more because I didn't know this and I don't like this. I think that's fine. But if I'm choosing who I'm going to apply my outrage to or in the defense of, it's not going to be these grown ass men that went to a strip club looking to pay for some pussy. And then they got drugged and robbed.
Well, since Tasha couldn't manipulate Derrick Jaxn into adopting her flawed ass point of view, she then tries to go in on him, insinuating that he was giving Cardi B a pass, trying to equate what she did with the drugging and raping of their victims that some of these male rappers have done. I'm calling it out. Public opinions from private accounts. I'm not a check, then you gotta bounce. I got the drip, come get it now. They do anything for clout. Do anything. Calling it out. Public opinions from private accounts. I'm not a check, then you gotta bounce. I got the drip, come get it now. They do anything for clout. Do anything for clout.
this girl giving her testimony, that's like such a reason to bring her down. I don't get it, man. And I'm not a fan of Cardi B or an opposer of Cardi B. I don't really try to keep up with that. She's just a really big topic. She's a really big topic. So I see a lot of selective outrage. A lot of it seems malicious. And it's just like, you know, it seems like a lot of her enemies. A lot of her enemies are now, because she has that video out, they get to hide behind this very valid reason to be mad at anybody, as if that's what they really care about and are invested in, when that ain't the truth. The real truth is they don't like Cardi B.
And with that, he hit the nail right on the damn head.
And I don't let nobody manipulate me on that type of shit. So, but y'all let me know what you think, man. I'm looking up in these.
So since she couldn't manipulate Mr. Derrick Jaxn into being one of her flying monkeys to help her destroy Cardi B, Tasha K, the narcissist, launched her own smear campaign against Derrick Jaxn. Check it out.
Bitches is mad, bitches is trash. Oscar the Grouch. Seeing me win, they gotta hurt. Ooh, ooh, ouch. So when they see me, what they gonna do? Bitch, not from the couch, back.
Do anything for clout.
I'm just curious why the outrage with this, you know, and because people were sitting there saying like hashtag surviving Cardi B, which, you know, what that's a playoff of. That's a playoff the whole surviving R. Kelly thing.
It's also a playoff of Sweet Mom for Life's video Surviving Tasha K, which was originally entitled Surviving a Narcissist.
Greater than the other, but there's levels to this shit. You know, stealing bubblegum out of a candy store is not the same as shooting up an elementary school. The same way Cardi B robbing dudes, drugging and robbing grown ass men who are looking to fuck her, is what she said. If they tried to fuck her, then she would drug them and rob them. Cardi B setting these dudes up, or whatever she did to rob them, is not the same as R. Kelly stealing underage children's innocence.
I had to go straight. I had to go, oh yeah, you wanna fuck me? Yeah, 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 let's go to this hotel. And I drug niggas up and I rob them. That's what I used to do. Nothing was motherfucking handed to me, my nigga, nothing.
She's not happy. She's not bragging. She's near tears, actually does come to tears, hysterical, you know, ranting and melting down.
Nobody wanted to fucking help me.
Why people don't give her due credit for all the work she's put in.